Hey there! Thanks for coming to my channel. These guys right here are my Patreon crew, and it's thanks to them that I'm able to make content and fill your days with fluffy blue kangaroos. I never once imagined my channel would go this far, so I am so insanely grateful to all my amazing patrons. But I'm also thankful to you just for being here, because I definitely couldn't have done it without people like you simply watching my stuff. So, thank you! Alright, let's get to the video. Enjoy!
Hello, YouTubes, and welcome to FurDU. We are at FurDU Down Under right now. It is halfway through the Sunday, and look who I have! I found the Biggs! It's Biggsy! And yeah, so we're just gonna do a little bit of a FurDU recap, I guess. Like, it's not over yet, but we'll share with you guys how it's been, and it's good to have the two different perspectives as well, from a local and someone who has come an extremely long way to be here. So FurDU Down Under has been running for nearly 10 years now, actually. Next year is going to be the 10th anniversary, so that's going to be a really good one. You should come to that one. And it is in Surfers Paradise on the Gold Coast in Queensland in Australia. And he's come all the way from the USA to be here, and I've come all the way from Brisbane in an hour drive. So Beagle, why do you choose to go to FurDU?
Well, I can't think of any con in the US that has a beach like yours.
Oh yeah. The views in the hotels are pretty mad.
Yeah, like if you just look out the hotel window, it's just like the back of a postcard.
Yeah, it really is. As for me, a local, I choose to go to FurDU because, yeah, one, it's close. It's very easy to get to. And two, it is Australia's biggest furry con. Like, this is where you go to meet pretty much any Australian furry. So how's your FurDU been going so far, Beagle?
It's been really good.
Yeah?
Yeah. Oh, it's been really good. I came here with a couple of my friends from the US this time, wanted to show them around, so...
Yeah, Kiwi's been hanging around, actually. We've been seeing some Kiwis.
Yeah, so we've just been going around the city a lot. We've been out more than in the hotel. But maybe it's because we're tourists, but it was really cool just to see all the food and restaurants.
Yeah, because you were saying most American cons are kind of confined to the hotel.
Yeah, because if you go to like any big American con like MFF, you're pretty much just in the building the whole time.
Okay.
And you don't really leave anywhere unless you can't get food. And then, well, I wanted to go to like a different restaurant every time.
Yeah, that's how you do it.
Because there's so many good places. That's what I remember about FurDU last time. I was just telling all my friends, like, there's so much good food, we have to like go to everything. Like, even the KFC here tastes better than America.
Oh yeah, really?
Yeah, that's what I heard. We haven't been there yet.
Oh, I haven't been there. Oh, let's take you.
Yeah.
Have we tried Macca's? All the Macca's?
Oh yeah, I had that once.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Is it true what they say, that our large size is your small size?
Yes, we had this discussion with my friends when we got off the, in the airport, we got Macca's, and then we're just like, this small cup is like half the size of our small cup. This medium is our small, and our large does not exist here.
Yeah, that's crazy. Like, I feel like that's something I'm gonna struggle with a lot when I go to America, is the portion
sizes. Yeah, we're gonna show you guys
I'm a little
two
scared.
American portions.
Like, I get called birdie stomach with how little I eat. Like, I have to get the kids' meals.
So fries versus chips here.
Yeah, there's a bit of a difference there. Cause like, yeah, we don't really say fries, like in some of the fast foods maybe, but otherwise not. Fries equals chips here, so like the actual deep fried strands of potato, and then what you call chips is just, I guess, chips here too. We don't really have a different name for
potato
products.
Chips, like the crunchy kind, you know?
Yeah.
So I had that in mind coming here. It just like, gotta say chips, not fries.
Yeah.
So I was at this American style restaurant here, and then the menu said burger and chips, so like, all right, let's get this. And then we got potato chips, like the crunchy kind of potato chips. I was just like so confused.
Yeah,
like,
it was a true American restaurant.
Yeah.
So what's been your favorite part of FurDU so far?
It was probably going down to the beach with my loop suit family our private photo shoot.
Your family reunion.
Yeah. So like early morning yesterday, we had about 30 of us went down to the beach for our own little private photo shoot. It was really nice and breezy out. And then it was just really cool getting to see a lot of our old friends and a lot of our new siblings.
Yeah.
All together.
Because the weather at the moment is really nice, because that's really good about FurDU's time of year. It's not too hot, it's not too cold, the weather doesn't rain too much, it's just really nice breezes as well, especially on the beach. You just get on the beach, it's like, breeze, wind.
The beach is just literally T-pose.
Yeah, T-posing on the beach, that was great.
The breeze.
I reckon that might be my favorite part of FurDU so far, was definitely the first bit walk. That was lots of fun, just seeing so many suitors just down there. Like, this is definitely the biggest photo so far. There would be easily like 200, maybe even 300 fursuits. It was easily like a 50-50 fursuiter to non-fursuiter ratio. It was just mental, because we don't do a fursuit parade, kinda. Like, because I know with American ones, you just kinda like walk throughout the hotel. There's not enough room here for that. So we go out of the hotel, down the street, and then onto the beach. And then we'll just kinda flock and mingle and do our big kinda photo shoot there. And they really struggled to get us all in this year.
Yeah, I don't think I've ever seen this many fursuiters that parade. Like, even at our like biggest American house, like Anthrocon,
yeah,
you probably have about equal amount of fursuiters in the parade as this con. Just because it's like, I don't know, a lot of people opt out of fursuit parades now, because they're just like, oh, you just walk in a circle around the hotel, it's kind of boring.
Yeah.
But here you go to the beach for like an hour, and then everyone's just hanging out.
Yeah.
You get the cool breeze, which is probably why everyone goes in the first place.
Yeah.
But it's just awesome to see like an endless amount of fursuiters streaming out of the hotel down the sidewalk.
It's the best photo opportunities as well, because this is where you go to find all the fursuiters. So you go find all the suits you want, take all your selfies, because there's nothing else we really do. We're just there hanging out. Like, we don't have to keep on walking.
We also get to terrorize the normie tourists.
I guess we get to terrorize the tourists. They're usually very good about it. Like, they'll come up to us with the kids, take the photos, and be like, what is this? What is going on? And then, you know, you go do the usual what's a furry spiel. Yeah.
Yeah.
I think they're pretty used to us now. We've been coming here nearly every year now. Also, there's the dealer's den this year as well. I think that was pretty big, pretty awesome. Did you buy anything from the dealers this year?
I got my usual, like, souvenir con.
Oh, yeah. Got to collect the con shirt.
Yeah.
But nothing from the actual dealers themselves.
No, I was suiting too much
to actually
pay attention. I was just saying hi to all my artist friends.
You need to like put your credit card in your floor, then everyone needs paperwork to just be like, boop, I want to buy that, boop, I want to buy that. I bought a nice tank from Daiku's workshop. She had some absolutely incredible stuff there this year. And of course my skunk sprays. I get these every year. It's my go-to fursuit spray for very nice. But yeah, just the overall quality of the dealers down this year was insane. Everyone was so professional and it's just really good.
Yeah.
This is so good.
We got interviewed in the dealer's den.
Oh yeah, we did too! Like, we got interviewed by the ABC. He was nice enough with his questions and stuff.
Yeah.
The article that came out wasn't too bad besides the headlines. I was not a fan of those headlines, it didn't need that. But for the rest of the article, that was alright. So, we think even someone else may have put the headline on there. Like, he probably had a nice one. And then ABC's like, nah, we need to make it more clickbaity.
Yeah.
And then did that. So, the guy himself was very nice. And we know FurDU wouldn't let in anyone that would paint us in a bad light. Here's the link to the article in the description if you want to see how it went. I was doing my live stream at that time as well.
Mm-hmm.
So that was interesting. The live stream went surprisingly well. Like, I reckon that's definitely my favorite live stream I've ever done.
Yeah, we had like 300 people.
Nearly 400, I think. Was the top. That was insane. And you came and helped me. You made sure that, like, everything was clean under the tables.
Oh yeah, it just emerged from beneath the table.
Yeah, it was magical, absolutely magical. Do you feel like there's anything that could have been improved on this year? Anything that wasn't quite as good as before? Anything that could be done better? They could let us record as times are.
Oh yeah.
So me and Beagle have been trying to do a collab for so long, and we are terrible at coming up with collab ideas. We have no idea. So we came up with the idea of going down to Time Zone, which is a game arcade, and doing like a red versus blue head-to-head battle game. People choose a game, I choose a game, keeper chooses a game, best out of three wins. Oh!
Yeah, we are like, we've been going through so many collab ideas, and then we finally came up with this, and then
we were there, we were ready.
Yeah, we paid for it and everything. We were filming the first game, and then this guy comes over and is like, oh, you can't film because there's families here, and it's...
Yeah. So I understand why, because, yeah, the families get a bit antsy about cameras and having their children around, so I get that. Like, I would have blurred their faces, but I understand, so gotta follow the rules, and they were like, well, we need a new idea, so here you go, here's a new idea. I'm sorry, it was probably not as exciting, but we still get to be here and I get to hang out with the bigs. I like the contrasting colors, it's really nice. Quite pleasing.
That was like the whole premise of Collab. It was like, you gotta do red versus blue.
Yeah, red versus blue, that's what we're trying to do. No, it didn't work. This is also the second time of us trying to film this one, because the GoPro didn't record, and it's like, this collab was just not meant to happen, I swear.
So our answers are like, all weird and...
Yeah, I apologize if the answers are a bit weird, because this is the second time we're doing this, it didn't work. So how does this FurDU compare to your last one?
Well, the first time I was here, like about 2 years ago, was I was just learning everything. I was like in a new country. This is my first time here. I'm traveling alone.
Yeah.
It was just like learning how to use your money, how to speak the language, even though it's the same language, but it's not.
Yeah. Like what? What do you have trouble with? Just the accents or?
It was just like a lot of like the phrases, like to get food to go, you say takeaway. To go, but they didn't understand when I said that.
Really?
I was like trying to.
I mean, that still makes sense. It's still a pretty broad term.
Yeah.
You get that? As for me, I reckon this is definitely the best FurDU yet. Like, I wasn't a huge fan of last year. Like, I'm not a fan of lots of panels. Like, I prefer to just have lots of cool, fun things to interact with, lots of things to do. And there was a lot of panels last year, so I didn't have a whole lot of fun, but it was still good. But this year, the schedule had been a lot more lax. Like, you don't feel like you have to be everywhere at once. It's just, it's chill. Chill.
Yeah, I feel chill. Like this... It doesn't feel like a fur con. It feels like an excuse to go on vacation with furries.
It really is. That's what I love about Aussie fur cons, because they're nice and small. It's not too crazy, and you just go and enjoy the area, enjoy being with people. There's a pool, you can go enjoy having a swim. I haven't done that yet. I need to go for a swim. So how does it compare to American cons?
I feel like American cons, like, if we're talking about the big American cons,
yeah.
You're just constantly scrambling to go to, like, photo shoots,
watch
shows. There's just so much stuff to do at big cons. You're always on the move. And you gotta like think things out beforehand, otherwise you're gonna miss something.
Huh.
But like this is a small con. Like it's the biggest con in Australia, but it would be considered a small con.
Yeah, like this year I'd say we got like upwards of 600, 700 people.
Yeah.
Which for America would be a pretty tiny con, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
So this is our biggest con.
Yeah, there's a lot of freedom here. Just,
freedom? Like, Australia is the true land of the free.
It's just because probably because this is like embedded in the middle of a tourist city. You can just go anywhere. Like you want food, just walk next door.
Yeah.
If you want food at MFF, you either buy the $40 hotel food or you walk 10 minutes through the Hall of Death.
Hall of Death?
You will get to see, if they don't fix it, you will get to see the Hall of Death.
What is the Hall of Death?
At MFF. It's our sky bridge off our...
Oh, is that the really hot one?
Yeah. Imagine walking outside here, but it's indoors.
That sounds really gross. overall, what would you say to people that are thinking about coming to FurDU from outside of Australia?
Definitely give it a go at least once. Like, I recommend anyone would go to an international con at least once, but FurDU is definitely my choice. I've been here twice already.
Yeah, it is the Australian one. If you want to go to an Australian FurCon, come to FurDU. It's the one, it's the best location, it's got the most people. It's good. And as for locals, you should come too, because it's a good party time. It's great. Yeah. That pretty much wraps us up.
Yep, we finally did it.
We
finished
did it.
Our collab.
Who knows? Maybe I turned off the GoPro and I'd be like, oh, there was an error. I'm like, no!
With the struggle for us to collab this weekend has been real.
If this doesn't work, our collab is going to be a selfie.
Yeah.
That's all we can do. thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. I'm sorry it wasn't the red versus blue battle that I've been promising, but it just wasn't going to work. Maybe next time, see how it goes. I mean, we can still punch him. There we go, blue wins.
Oh, MFF.
MFF, we'll think of something at MFF. Maybe, I don't know, we probably still won't think of something. We are terrible.
Yeah.
If you have any ideas, please let us know in the comments, please. We need ideas, please give us ideas. All right, thank you for watching. You want to say anything, last minute thing to the people?
Like, comment, subscribe.
I actually never tell people to subscribe. I just want you to comment. I like comments.
Donate to her Patreon so we can keep bringing her back to America.
All right. Thank you so much for joining me, Beagle, on this collab that hopefully worked.
Yeah.
Yeah. And we will see you guys next time. And there's going to be another collab on his channel as well, because we're doing the beeps. Beep, 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 beep. Go to his channel. See you next time. Thanks for watching. Bye. Bye.